Like, everything I do is gold. Why aren't we recording right now?
Literally, I was like, guys, this is the moment.
This is it. This is
the world needs to hear.
Welcome to Tea in the Garden. We should sip tea right after that.
I know. I was just thinking, none of us have tea, and that's kind of lame.
No, it's okay.
Chink.
Welcome to Tea in the Garden.
THC in the garden.
First up on the docket today, Pluto. Who wants to tell them?
What's going on with Pluto, my astrology girls?
Well, it's in Capricorn, but it's leaving Capricorn and moving into Aquarius, but it's passing through Capricorn just in the last bit while the new moon is in Capricorn too. So it's like, I feel like there's a lot of lessons being completed. Listen. And isn't Pluto's like the destroyer, right? So it's all about like,
Wait, what? Where did those balloons come from?
Hold on. I was doing this today in class too, and things happen.
Things? Wait, what was the balloon? Oh. Why does yours do that, but mine doesn't?
I wonder if that's the new Mac.
Yeah, because ours doesn't do that ever.
No, it's Zoom. Like, but when you do this.
We're not on Zoom. We're not on Zoom.
Oh, well, I don't know. I guess it's the Mac then.
We seem like we are, like, literally, like, boomer moms who just got on a Zoom call for the first time.
Oh, wow. Did you see what it did there?
What's happening? Oh,
why is it a Midwest?
Oh, my God. Is it? Does it show out here or is it only on the screen?
Honey, can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Oh, honey, I don't think it's working. John, I don't think they can hear us.
I don't. Can the kids see us? Can the kids see us?
What?
Oh, that Lady Betty. She's commenting on my photo again on Facebook. She always comments, but she never likes the post.
What's the one that kills me that is like, it's like doesn't even seem like it could be real, but it's real. Is that what's that neighbor that like neighborhood app that like
next door
like breeds the like weirdest, most sad about their lives, like middle-aged people who are like, did you see that sketchy man parked out front? There was a kid trying to be with his girlfriend and be lock your doors tonight because folks they're coming around. It's so sad.
Or like they post a picture of a squirrel in a tree.
Yeah.
The neighborhood squirrel. He's looking fat. Who's feeding him?
You know, you're not supposed to feed the wildlife. It hurts.
I don't
them.
Know anything about that because they're always talking about me and them.
Like, I've
never
that.
Included.
Are we
you
sure
that hippie witch that? Lady? She was smoking pot again on the front porch doing her drumming.
So accurate though.
Doing her drumming. That's hilarious.
You know, oftentimes when we think and talk and get into tea, it's about people. It's about other people, right? It's gossip. So we're here for the cosmic gossip.
The cosmic gossip.
Yeah, we're not here to talk shit about people. We're here to talk shit about the universe.
And here's what I want to say about Pluto.
Okay.
The super Pluto, you stupid ass, ratchet ass hoe.
Stupid Oompa Loompa looking ass.
Oompa Loompa body ass bitch. Yeah, so Pluto has spent 15 years in Capricorn, moved into Aquarius, and then the last 6 months retrograded, touched Aquarius, and then retrograded back into Capricorn for 6 months, and it has gone direct, and now it is moving forward on January 20th to Aquarius, where it will spend the next 15 years. It's a new generation. It's a new era.
So epic. Mm-hmm. Yo, our cosmic children are going to be Pluto Aquarius.
They won't even be Gen Alphas. They'll be Betas. No.
Is that actually what they're calling them?
No, I don't know what they're going to call it. What would you name
that has no, I don't accept that.
She's like, absolutely not. That is not the name.
I would name them enlightened beings.
The cosmic baddies.
That will go great for the media.
Yeah.
It should be Jen Batty.
My baby's a baddie.
It's a little baddie baby. You know, like a Gen X, Gen Batty. What?
Oh, that's so bad.
Yeah. Who gets to choose what they're called, you know? Who chooses that?
It's a great question.
We should call them.
We should get that job.
Is it like a historian?
I have no idea, but what could we expect to be the difference between Pluto being Capricorn all these years and now moving into like Aquarius full time? What do you foresee collectively being like the societal feeling and shift around that?
Well, the last time that Pluto was in Aquarius, we saw a massive amount of revolutions.
Yeah, as soon as you say Aquarius, I think revolutionary. It's like the oddball, I'm not going to do it your way. I'm going to march to the beat of my own drum, kind of, which is really good. And I think we just need to be cautious in, like, because we are still in Capricorn season until we move into Aquarius season, like, it's still time for us to, like, decide what it is that we're jumping into, because once we do get into Aquarius season, like, I feel like that's where everything is implemented and we can kind of like, that's where we can kind of kick our own ass in a way by jumping into things too quickly, where Capricorn is very much like, no, let's think about this. Like, let's be responsible. Let's look at everything and see the full picture. Aquarius can kind of be a great feature, but also sometimes a downfall, be kind of aloof. So I think this is like our last few moments before we actually jump to make sure like everything's where we want it to be to do that, especially like level up thing. Yeah.
Ooh. I love that. And isn't it like, it's really community oriented too though, right? So I feel like another aspect will be that, right?
Yeah, definitely.
We're going to see a lot of technological advancement as well. Social media is not going fucking anywhere. I believe that the next true currency will be attention.
It already kind of is, you know? Yeah, exactly. It's rapidly only going more and more that direction. So that's really interesting. Yeah, I feel like Aquarius vibes very alien.
I like it's like weirdo energy, like owning it.
Yeah, I love it.
Yeah.
Aquarius is still ruled by Saturn, though, just like Capricorn. The only time in the zodiac where we see ruling planets stay the same as we change planets.
Wow.
That's another reason why I think it's like a refining. It's like a level up. It's because we're still in the same sign, like, but we have all this wisdom now to apply. Even like if you think about like the last year, because last year's new moon in Capricorn was like the 22nd degree, I think. And this year it's the 21st degree. Okay. So it's like, I think a call to review, like, what have you learned last year and how are you going to apply that now to everything that you're doing, because I feel like everything's changing, but like in such a good way, especially for our signs too, like Cancer, Aries, Libra, Virgo, even like it's a lot of change and shift is happening because of the North Nodes and all that. It's just so much shift, so much change in such a good way, I think.
Yeah. Your Aquarius placements will feel this, and any cardinal sign placements.
Yeah, I saw, I think they said, it was said Leo too, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's so interesting.
I'm sorry, not cardinal, you're fixed. What am I?
Yeah, fixed.
You're fixed. There we go. So that would be Leo, Taurus, Aquarius, and...
Cancer?
No.
No, Cancer's a cardinal sign.
Scorpio.
Oh.
Scorpio's fixed.
Mm. Wow. Yeah, and it's like, I feel the energy this year is very, like, lucky kind astrology, though, I feel. Mm-hmm. And, like, just collective energy, like, it feels, so many people have even, like, commented, like, a lot of our students have said, even though there is obviously a lot of crazy stuff happening in the world right now, and it's not to take away from that, there's this weird feeling of, it's everything is going to be okay.
Mm-hmm.
And like things are kind of falling into place in weird ways. And we're going through it still right now, but I think we're entering the other side, you know, this year. And I'm curious what that's going to look like.
There's a lot of people who don't feel that way. There's a lot of people who, especially amongst the younger generation, I'm looking at you, Zoomers, where it's on trend to live in disdain and hopelessness, like wanting to unalive yourself is like becoming a new base.
Yeah, I don't get behind that.
No, I know, but that's,
I think
like
it's
a very
just another perspective to tap into, right? Like, it depends on what how you're looking at it.
Right.
Of course. But I'm saying that's a Saturn aspect of like being mm-hmm. pushed to mm-hmm. your limit.
Totally.
And like
totally.
Holding the end of the rope.
Yeah, it's true. Very confronting.
So I think that will not change in the mm-hmm. younger part of the collective.
Mm, that's so interesting.
And so it's like, so if you're there. It's actually hot. It's really freaking sexy and hot and gorgeous to have hope.
Yeah.
So if you want to be a hot girl.
Oh my God.
Savannah.
What's really hot and what's really cool is being is being radically heart opened and loving.
Oh.
And so hopeful. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
So hopeful. It's positive girl era.
Mm-hmm. What hopeful era girl, are you guys entering?
Hopeful girly era.
I feel like I'm just getting over my villain era.
Oh, I'm over it. Like, oh, it's gone. Like, over.
Yours happened over a while ago.
Yeah, that's done.
I feel like I'm in my getting swept off my feet era.
Oh, cute. You deserve that era.
Yeah.
Thanks, Isis.
That's a crazy story we'll have to share on this podcast.
Yeah. Yeah, we can have story time. We'll tell the story of Isis and how she swept through our lives to clear out anything that wasn't in alignment.
Yeah.
Very quickly, literally you and me, Prasiddha, at the same exact time, the same exact timeline, everything.
Hey guys, if you ever, anyone watching, listening, if you ever need a husband, just come to my house.
we'll do the work and it'll happen.
It's so far 100% effective.
The formula
like,
is,
can't even argue.
The formula is send someone you love to Egypt to do offerings for you. Come together to Savannah's house, do spell work and candles with your coven. There you go. Done deal. Just a little bit of that, a little bit of this.
And more on this topic, did you know, just this just in, did you know you could literally write the script of your reality? Breaking news.
I didn't realize how much our podcast was going to be so cringe for Gen Z.
Oh, yeah.
You know what? It is. I want them to cringe so
hard. I hope they cringe out of their shell.
I hope that they cringe, because I was just addressing the younger generation.
Oh, God.
I hope that they cringe so hard that it sends them into a frenzy wherein they have no chance but to see the face of God.
Yes.
Huzzah. They breathe throughout the other end.
Yeah. That's hilarious. What are you guys most excited to talk about and like open conversations about on our podcast? I would love to hear.
Honestly, I love just freeballing it. So my most excited part is that it's just like open conversation. I feel like that's what I enjoy the flow of it, you know? So I think that's going to be exciting, because we're going to start with one topic and I think we'll end on a whole other, as we do, which I think is the whole reason we thought that this would be a good idea in the first place.
So true.
I'm most excited to share personal, vulnerable experiences and stories.
Facts.
I can do one right now if you're interested.
Please kick it off.
Okay. Obviously, we know it's post-holiday time now, and I have not been getting lifts in the gym like I wanted to, and I have been eating a lot of carbohydrates. And today after the shower, I stepped on the scale and it fucking triggered me. And it triggered me pretty bad. But I was so aware of it when it was happening that I was like, I'm not gonna go and do this. I'm basically not gonna try to like exercise control over what I'm like feeling right now. And I wasn't feeling angry, maybe a little frustrated, but I was just like sad and a little bit anxious. So I definitely felt that pull to like just go sit on the couch and wallow and just continue to feel worse and spiral. But instead I took the dogs for a 40-minute walk. So I really got to move my body and my lymph, and it's very cold here. I suited up. I was looking like the Michelin man. It was 36 Fahrenheit. I took them for the walk. They were so happy. They're like sound asleep now. And I cried on my walk. So imagine I'm suited up. Okay, I look like I'm in Alaska. It's only 36 Fahrenheit, but I'm from Florida. And I'm walking the dogs. I got gloves, I got a hat, I got like many layers. I'm walking the dogs. There's like crisp air in my face. The sun is starting to set. And I'm walking in the suburbs of Detroit with these two massive dogs. I'm holding them like a chariot, and I'm just crying. And I can't wipe my face that well because I have two dogs in my hand.
Were your tears like oozing on your face? Through, like, turning into icicles.
Yeah. Yeah, and a lot of cars definitely drove by me, but I was just having my hot girl walk with a little
hot girl walk crying.
And it's such a dumb, I know that like logically it's so stupid, but you know, that's just old pain, right? That's just
exactly.
The fact of the matter is I'm sexy as hell, and
facts.
That's an objective fact. And it's so crazy because I've never struggled with like body image, really, a little bit, right? I think every woman does. And I've never struggled with like eating disorders or anything like that. And still like that pain is just right fucking there and available. For what?
Yeah.
I'm supposed to put on a couple pounds.
Right. And like literally, I think sometimes these things, I really believe from my own experiences, we're feeling like the pain body of the whole female collective. Like, especially when it's when it's like PMS or cycle related stuff, sometimes like something will come out that is totally, I know, like, actually not my thing, like, not my personal story or like my personal pain. And I'm like, where? I'll be like, where is this coming from? And then I'm like, oh yeah, like that's actually a thing that happens, especially with our cycle and bleeding. Like, it's really, really fascinating. You know, that reminds me, Sav, of this week. I was also going through my own old pain, and what was coming up for me, since I even told you guys on our meeting, like, I was feeling a little frustrated and at myself, because I had all these like really lofty goals for December and the beginning of this month, and like none of them happened. And I had met my measure of success for myself being those things, and me not achieving those things, it gives me like identity crisis. It gives me like, as many times as I've worked through this thing, you know, it happens a lot more gentle now and a lot more subtle, but still, you know, there's like things that come up for me where I feel this, like, I feel like I'm a failure, like that my own like expectations of my performance ability are like, you know, and I hold these really high standards for myself.
That's on former gifted child.
Oh yeah. That is on former gifted child. So whew, that one is coming up for me a lot this last few weeks, actually. And I think actually now that I'm articulating it too, I'm realizing even deeper, I think it wasn't just that I didn't hit those specific goals, quote unquote. It was that I didn't work for 2 weeks and actually took a break. And I think my self-image or worth like is completely tied to that. So the fact that I didn't do shit for 2 weeks, I'm like, who am I? Even though I enjoyed it, you know, like a huge part of me completely enjoyed that and is able to do that now, which is a huge like leap in and of itself. I didn't even used to be able to check out like at all. Like I wouldn't, you know? So it was so nice.
A year ago this time I was there.
Yeah.
I totally like the addiction to the whip cracked upon my back.
Yep.
But we work so hard and so smart to be able to rest. And then we get there and we're like, wait, it worked?
Yeah.
What do you mean?
Yeah, right. And then as soon as I get into one of these lower points in my energy, right? Or like that frustration, which is the unself, right? Of manifesting generator, like I immediately go towards, oh, I should have done more. Like that's like immediately where my mind goes is like, I was the problem and I could have done more. You know? So that's interesting, you know, to just like watch that happen, but then also know that's, like you said, an old pain. Like it doesn't have to be the story, but it arises.
Bye, Lauren. We said it, only hot girls open their heart.
I'm thinking. I think for me, it's just been like taking a look at my life and deciding like what I'm going to keep in it and what I'm not, you know, like it's been very clear, conscious decision making and intentional like removal and inclusion of what's in my life on many levels. And one of those levels is obviously, yeah, like my calling and my personal life and my personal growth and, you know, all of it. And so, you know, those are the lessons that I'm learning right now and of what I deserve and what I'll tolerate and what is minimum and what is from myself and from others and, you know, just in general. But I do allow myself a lot more grace now than I ever have, like taking that space, you know, over the break to take a break. Like that was wild.
Yeah.
That was wild and gives so much clarity, you know, but we had to set up the structure in order to make that possible. And mm-hmm. now that we've had the time, now we have like all these ideas and, you know, things to move forward. So, yeah.
That's I was saying, so I actually said the culling, like last year, the amount that you cut out of your life.
Oh, yeah.
Last year? So true. Oh, yeah. Well, so I've been in such a transition period since August, right? Like nonstop since August, but the culling started in February of 2023. Mm-hmm. Of me like starting to release different contract work that I was doing and different responsibilities and other businesses. And, you know, yeah. so it has been like a long transition, but then just reflecting recently, it's been like a very intense period since August of transition, release, clarity, decision-making, release, et cetera, et cetera.
It's so, Saturn.
I love it though. I'm here for it. I always say I thrive in chaos, and I do. Like every time shit like this happens, I come back better. So like now when this kind of stuff happens, I just lean in. Yeah. And yeah, I think that's what absolutely. We teach our students, right? We just teach them like, we've been here before. Like you can do this. Trust fall, believe us. Like that's, we're not like teaching them anything like super secret. We're just mm-hmm. teaching super powerful tools, I think.
Speak for yourself. If you want to call them that.
And like experience and then, you know, guiding them through experience as they experience it.
So true. But,
you know,
that's also on survival of long-term PTSD.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
No, we all that. Oh, wait, you're telling me you thrive when there's chaos? Like I know that song. I know that tune. But no, it does become our superpower, like quite literally. And mm-hmm. so many of us in the healing work, we are born into situations like that, and it gives us the skill sets to literally be emergency responders. Like we are emergency mm-hmm. responders, and we are like we run into it. You know, we run into the storm, and
yep.
we're trained for that. You know, life trains us for that. Universe, spirit trains us for that. And it becomes a superpower, you know, and then we have to learn, like we've just been talking about, we all actually had to learn the opposite of what some people have to learn. Some people have to learn how to do that, how to do more, act more, take more initiative. We have to learn how to turn off and relax and receive.
Yeah. Stop.
Yeah, we do. And we've all, I know, had such a journey, like getting more into our healthy feminine receiving for our own lives in many ways, mm-hmm. in many aspects, because we've all been very hyper independent, self-made, creative, entrepreneurial beings. So, you know, yeah it's so interesting. Okay, guys, shall we wrap up for our first episode?
Yeah, I named this episode, Welcome, We Have ADHD and Soft Heart.
Wait, that is like the best title ever. Okay, you win for like titling all the episodes.
Yay. She's like, as a Virgo, I accept because I already appointed
like,
myself.
Like, I was already doing that.
All right, yay, this is great. We'll do it again.
Okay, we're getting the ball rolling. As we said, guys, we're here to build the boat as we're swimming. So
yeah,
we're not starting this with some perfect vision and like millions of prep. We're starting it to start it. And I actually take
we're just getting action. The content. We're getting the content.
All right. So we will conclude this episode. Thank you all so much for listening to our ADHD rambles. We can't wait to have more hilarious, spiritual, cosmic, and out there conversations, because we are a very multidimensional bunch, and that's what we love about each other. So we promise to keep you entertained, I think. That much we can say.
Yep. Yep. All right. Well, deuces.
All right. Bye, everyone.